Hey you guys, before we get into this video, please, please, please subscribe and like. The craziest thing happened as soon as I was done editing this video, which took 2 hours to actually edit. My video editing software just crashed and everything got lost, so I have to re-edit this just for you guys. So please do subscribe and like. Sorry for wasting your time, let's get right into the video. Ice boy, walking, oh that's high, yeah, they can't tell me why, word, I don't even need no lies, ay, got my own little spy, ay, lure me in my. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, and today we're going to be talking about DS4 Windows and how to set it up with your controller. So guys, the first thing you're going to want to do is actually go to DS4 Windows. So go ahead in the description and there should be a link called DS4 Windows. Go ahead and click on that and then it should bring you to this page. Now once you're at this page, go ahead and go to the top and go to the latest version. Go ahead and just click on it, and then once you click on it, you should be brought to a new page. Go ahead and scroll down so you see these, then download the 64.zip. Once it's done downloading, just go ahead and open it up using WinRAR, and if you don't have WinRAR, go ahead and install it. Click on DS4 Windows, but don't double click it. Go to desktop. Click on desktop, click OK. Okay, so now once it's extracted to the desktop, go ahead and exit out and go to the desktop and open up the folder. Look for the DS4 Windows, click on it. Okay, so for me, I already have everything set up, but for you, you're gonna need to do some extra steps. If you need any help with that, please comment down below and I'll help you. So go ahead and go to the bottom right, click on start, and then your controller should pop up here. Go over to the profiles tab and click on new, top left. It's gonna say, do you want to use a preset option? Choosing no will cause the purple letter to use an empty gamepad profile. Click on no. Okay guys, the very first thing once you get here is because I know once you're using this, there can be a lot of errors. So okay guys, so the first thing you're gonna wanna do is go over to other, scroll down to see BT pull rate, click on it and click max 1 millisecond. So this will get you the best input delay. Now scroll down, see an emulated controller, and then do the controller that you're using. So if you're using Xbox, do Xbox 360. And if you're using DualShock, do DualShock 4, which is the PS4 controller. I'm doing the PS5 controller, so I'll do DualShock 4. Okay, so now that I've entered DualShock 4 in max 1 millisecond, what you're gonna do is go to the top left, and as you can see, it says profile. Go ahead and put in a name for it, so any name that I'll just put mine as Joe Mama. Okay, so now once that's done, go ahead and click on save. Now it should be saved. Jojo Mama, go ahead and go back into it. Okay, so now once that's done, you should be getting better input delay. So now what you're gonna wanna do is come over to the bottom left and then basically just map these with the corresponding thing. So for this one, it's gonna be X, so I'll double click it and then click on X. It's already mapped for you, but it could be causing issues if you have a newer controller, like a PS5 controller and some PS4 controller. So just go ahead and redo all of it. It won't take that long. It'll take like 2 minutes. So let me just do it real quick. The next thing you want to do is actually mess with your dead zones, and if you have a lot of drift, go ahead and just put it higher. And if you don't get any drift and you want a faster response time, you can go ahead and put it lower. My controller has absolutely no drift at all, so what I do is actually put it to 0, max zone, and this to 0. And then I'll just go ahead and do that for everything else. So guys, only do this if you have no drift at all. And if you don't know what drift is, it's basically like your controller moving by itself, like your character moving by itself by the joystick. And if you have a lot of drift, go ahead and just put this up from where it was. I would recommend putting it to like 0.10 or something like that, or whatever you feel comfortable with. You can just go ahead and mess around with that. Okay, now we're gonna wanna go over to controller readings, and then this is where you're gonna get your milliseconds. As you can see, I have 0 milliseconds because I did a trick, and if you guys want me to release the trick, I'll do another video on that. Please comment down below if you wanna know the trick to get 0 milliseconds in your controller. It's actually very easy and very simple, but I don't have time to do it in this video. So yeah guys, just go ahead and comment down below if you actually want me to drop a tutorial on that. Okay, so the next thing you're gonna wanna do is go over to touchpad, output mode, go and put it to controls. And then you can go ahead and assign this to whatever you want. This is basically like the D-pad or whatever you want to do. Guys, also make sure to be clicking apply after every single step. For rotation and fuzz, you guys don't need to worry about that. For the curve and for the output curve, I use linear. If you don't know what any of this, I would recommend not changing it. But if you do, you can go ahead and change it if you want. But for me, I just stick with linear, which in my opinion, I think is the best. So yeah, as you guys can see for my dead zones, I have it at 0 because I don't get any drift. And yeah. Okay, guys, now after all this, just go ahead and click apply and then click save. And then make sure your controller that's plugged in either wirelessly or through USB, make sure it's selected on your profile, the one that you created, and it should have the same name as the one you actually created. Now right here, as you can see, there's a color. So you can go ahead and go over to custom color and you can change this to whatever you want. And it should appear on your touchpad if you're using PS4. Or for your Xbox, it's not gonna show up. But if you're using a PS4, it should show up around your touchpad. So for me, I personally like this color, like around here. This is what I like to use. Now, guys, once you make sure that your controller is plugged in, you have the right profile that's selected, just go ahead and go over to the settings. And then as you can see, go ahead and make sure it's checked as run at startup and make sure it's run as a program. So this will make sure to run this program every time you set up your computer, so you don't have to redo this every single time that you start up your computer. And if you guys don't want it on for whatever reason, just go ahead and uncheck that, but I'm gonna have it on. Also, guys, an extra tip, once you're in your profile and you're at light bar, flash at 0%. So basically what this does is, let's say you put it to 10% and then put the color to red. So basically what this does is, once your controller is at 10%, like it's low, the touchpad will actually flash red. So personally, I think that's pretty cool, because it'll let you know when your controller is low and when it's gonna die. So if you guys want, you can go ahead and mess with this and whatever, but yeah. Also in Gaara, make sure your output mode is control, same as touchpad and same as axis config. Make sure they're all as controls. So guys, that's gonna be actually it. That's gonna be everything we're going through today. If this video did help you guys, please make sure to like and subscribe. It really will mean a lot just to subscribe, just to hit one button. Please comment down below if this worked for you, or if you had any issues. I'll be responding to all the comments with issues, and I'll try to help you to the best of my ability. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you have a good day, and peace out.